What is demanded is a progressive knowledge of the universe. At this time, to say that it is matter, that universe is of matter, when they know that even the concept of matter springs from the mind, is stupidity. The first thing is to explore the mind before they start exploration of matter. This is the wonder in us, wonder of wonders. You can only know the incredible nature of this wonder when Kundalini is awake. When we explore nature or the universe, we see law after law, and consciousness is seen as the queen of creation.
Why is there so much resistance to the idea that the brain is still evolving?
You see, acceptance of this idea would place science in a quandary. Now, if the brain is evolving, where? What mechanism is responsible for it? Then secondly, if it is evolving in a certain predetermined direction, it means that evolution is planned. That will create confusion in the present materialistic or mechanistic concepts of modern science. It will be a very terrible day when the experiments done on Kundalini are proved.
Will they be accepted?
How can they be ignored? We will invite applications also from people who have awakened Kundalini. There will be hundreds of thousands all over the world. Then the experiment. If we had the resources, I think in 10 years we could create a climate by our research and study, also by experiments, which would force science to accept. There is no question. And then even scientists proceed with this investigation. Not only once, but maybe for centuries to come. And the experiments will confirm each other. What alternative will they have? They accept what we see. You can see it is a consistent explanation of everything that you see. Of war, of peace, of future, of one world. Even the people are now beginning to realize. Many people now wish that there were no wars, that people were allowed to live in peace, that the old standards are wrong, that values should be changed. Why? Because this is the instinctive urge in many minds, and this corresponds to what I say. Just I should have time, by the grace of heaven, to record all that I have to say. And the evidence is in the civilizations of the past, their rise and fall. In the rise and fall of dynasties, rich families, and aristocracy. In fact, in the whole history of the past, in the appearance of prophets and enlightened beings, in the appearance of geniuses from time to time in every subject, every branch of knowledge, to help mankind to go ahead. Otherwise, there is no reason why there should be a genius, and that genius should be so eager to give something new to the earth. It is because of this urge of evolution. There is also no reason why.
To the idea that the brain is still evolving.
You see, acceptance of this idea would place science in a quandary. Now, if the brain is evolving, where? What mechanism is responsible for it? Then secondly, if it is evolving in a certain predetermined direction, it means that evolution is planned. That will create confusion in the present materialistic or mechanistic concepts of modern science. It will be a very terrible day when the experiments done on Kundalini are proved.
Will they be accepted?
How can they be ignored? We will invite applications also from people who have awakened Kundalini. There will be hundreds of thousands all over the world. Then the experiment. If we had the resources, I think in 10 years we could create a climate by our research and study, also by experiments, which would force science to accept us. There is no question. And then even scientists proceed with this investigation, not only once, but maybe for centuries to come. And the experiments will confirm each other. What alternative will they have? They accept what we see. You can see it is a consistent explanation of everything that you see. Of war, of peace, of future, of one world. Even the people are now beginning to realize. Many people now wish that there were no wars, that people were allowed to live in peace, that the old standards are wrong, that values should be changed. Why? Because this is the instinctive urge in many minds, and this corresponds to what I say. Just I should have time, by the grace of heaven, to record all that I have to say. And the evidence is in the civilizations of the past, their rise and fall. In the rise and fall of dynasties, rich families, and aristocracy. In fact, in the whole history of the past, in the appearance of prophets and enlightened beings, in the appearance of geniuses from time to time in every subject, every branch of knowledge to help mankind to go ahead. Otherwise, there is no reason why there should be a genius and that genius should be so eager to give something new to the earth. It is because of this urge of evolution. There is also no reason why a large percentage of mad people should be megalomaniacs or claim to be great poets, great philosophers, great heroes, great conquerors, great prophets. It is because Kundalini is morbidly awake and they have that evolved mind but disoriented. You will find consistency in what I say. It is only blind prejudice that is preventing scholars from accepting and experimenting on it. This is the frontier of knowledge which science must reach if mankind is to survive. And it will be reached. Not only that, maybe either someone in a lunatic asylum, or some scientist, or some great man in power may suddenly be confronted by an awakened Kundalini, either in himself or in his own offsprings. That will focus attention on the phenomena. Yeah. That is the reason why I say, let what I say be recorded. That should be your effort. Yeah. Let nothing escape. Let it be put in black and white, in tapes, in books. Let it be accumulated. Let it be put in a printed form somewhere. Only even a few hundred copies. The time will come when every line will be read by people in search of this law. Just I should have time, by the grace of heaven, to put down all that I have to say. You may be sure that it will be accepted, it will provide guidance for the future, and maybe for hundreds, even thousands of years. Because it is by an unusual combination of circumstances that I have survived so far. Accumulate this knowledge so that we may be able to place as much of this knowledge on record as is possible. There is much to be said on politics, on science, on economics, on everything, on the brain, on the human body. In future, there will be people who will have the same awakening. They will like to have every bit of information to save themselves. It is a terrible power. It is not just what these people claim. It is a leap from one dimension of consciousness into another, from one world into the other. It's not a small matter. It's a terrific experience. But somehow, by the grace of heaven, I have survived the ordeal and I'm here talking to you.